Shalom Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Benoon Institute of Biblical Research. And the message tonight, the rise of independence, a sign of prophecy. This is something that's going to be airing on Israeli News Live as well, mainly because we're looking at the news in prophecy and how this is being fulfilled. First, I want to just kind of share with you here just a little bit. But don't stop dropping the microphones on the ground. I want to share with you just some recapping of different news we've been watching transpire. And some of this has been over the years and even decades, and some of it more recently in the news, especially the case of Catalonia independence, the huge Barcelona pro-Spain rally. And of course, everybody's been following this in the news and how that they have voted for their own independence in the northeastern part of Spain, trying to secede from the Spanish government, cracking down on them very severely and trying to stop this trend. But it didn't start with Catalina. We can go back and look also. The people power delivers a new blow to Brussels as Italy's regions backs more independence, that being that of Lombardy and Veneto. These are the richer regions of northern Italy that are, as they say, sick and tired of having to foot the bill for the poor regions. You know, it's kind of interesting because, see, Rome is not in that particular category. Rome is considered in the poorer category in this here. And you can't but wonder if they don't feel like that they're having to support the bill in Rome there altogether. But they're not saying that per se. But even Sicily is also trying to secede from Italy as well, as another thought there. And of course, we have, you go to the Middle East, we have the Kurdish leader, the Barzani's dream of independence led to a downfall. And yet they did a referendum trying to declare independence in the northern part of Iraq. It looks like they may try to declare independence in eastern Syria with the help of the United States. They have a lot of troubles inside of Turkey with Erdogan cracking down when nearly, I would say, over a third of the eastern part of Turkey is predominantly Kurdish people living there. So again, it's an ethnic uprising if you really begin to look at it. And then we can back up a little bit. When the Maidan uprising happened in Ukraine, where the Western Ukrainians, who were more pro, it was actually more of a pro-Nazi uprising, turned against the predominantly Russian-speaking Ukrainians who were to the far east of the country and even in Crimea. And Donetsk gears up for its own independence and referendum. Of course, back in 2014, they have since declared their independence, as well as the Luhansk region, Crimea. Russia helped to make sure that they were protected and pulled out of Ukraine altogether. And then there's been other independence push, such as that of Texas, talking about seceding the Union. Will that ever happen? Well, the question is, we don't really know, but more than likely, I would think not in the United States, but it doesn't mean that it would not take place. But if you'll keep in mind what a lot of these different independence moves have to do with biblical prophecy. And we're going to look at the biblical prophecy of Matthew 24 in just a moment, but I want you to keep in mind, even Catalina, Catalonia, this is a ethnic type of situation. Although they're Spanish, but they're a different people from that of the particular main Spaniards there. If you look at Ukraine, you have the Russian Orthodox of the East, and the Western Ukrainians are more pro Roman Catholic to the West. Texas, you don't have so much that there. It's just Texans are sick and tired of the rest of the United States and the way that the economy is being run. We can go back and we can look at, say, for example, the Kurdish people as well. Again, another ethnic, religious type faction, a different people altogether from that of the Sunni Muslim or the Shiite Muslim or the Alawites, etc. We could look at the situation in Italy. Now, I don't know if Italy is so much as a ethnic difference as it is an economic struggle that is happening in the country there. But most of these are actually more of an ethnic battle in the nations there, not counting Texas, that is. But then we have this latest call. I actually watched a video with Louis Farrakhan recently, watched quite a bit of the video, as Mr. Farrakhan was calling for a separate nation for the black people that have suffered in the United States due to slavery and the laws of the past of this country here. And although I understand and I do appreciate his fight for the black people of America and the oppression that they have suffered because of slavery. And, you know, it's an appalling time in our history, no doubt about it. But as he's doing the same thing, it is still another ethnic type of situation asking that the United States do something to give the black community their own state, whether it be in the United States or, as he even put it this time around here, whether it be abroad somewhere. But again, how do you create another state like this for an ethnic minority without uprooting another group of people to make way for that? And his argument was this time here that the United States has been supporting Israel all these years, and the U.S. could also help support starting a state for the black people. So, again, as much as I appreciate the struggle and the reasoning behind it, it seems almost impossible. And that's not really the issue I'm looking at here. What I'm looking at now, though, is that Jesus himself, Yeshua, actually prophesied of these types of struggles that would be happening. Not only that, but, you know, look at Europe. Every one of these places here, we have these people trying to rise up for independence. Even in the Czech Republic on the eastern part of the Czech Republic, you have, they're calling it the Czech Sicilia, which is right up here in the very far northeastern corner, Moravia down here to the south part, and of course the ones up here, the Czech Sicilia, they're more Polish than they are Czech, and that's why they want to secede. Then you got a place here, and you have a place over here in, says, I can't even pronounce the word there, Sizikli land, and I don't even, can't think of right off the top of my head which country they're actually in there. We have the situation Lombardy-Veneto in Italy. We have Bavaria in Austria, or no, I'm sorry, that's not Austria, that's Germany there, that wants to secede from Germany. You have the Flanders, you have Scotland wanting to secede, you've got part of Northern Ireland want to secede from Ireland, you have, Catalonia in Spain, you have another province there in Spain, you have Sicily trying to get out of there, Corsica has proposed autonomy as well. All these autonomy independent movements that are happening, and then you look at that, and I'm going to go into just a minute, not just the individuals, or, and they're not even showing Ukraine and the situation in Ukraine there, over here in Ukraine, where you have Donetsk, Luhansk regions over in here, you have Crimea down here in the south that already has seceded in its independence from Ukraine. But the thing is that we're looking at biblical prophecy, and we're looking at biblical prophecy in a way that I have, you know, I have totally not caught this part of the prophecy. Let's take a look at Matthew 24 once again. And of course, I'm only looking at this to show the timeline we're living in. The question is asked to Jesus, and it, as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, "Tell us, when shall these things be, and what shall be the sign of thy coming, and in the end of the world?" And Jesus answered and said unto them, "Take heed that no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many." Now, by the way, that's the same thing as the abomination that maketh desolate. And I went through that in another teaching. I don't have time to go into it this time here. But what he was talking about is that they would put in his place an abomination, a filthiness that would bring about desolations over the earth. That was the papacy. The papacy of Rome is the abomination of desolation, and it is a plural when you begin to look at it, that they bring about the destruction. Because why? They say peace and safety, and there is no peace. And this is what Yeshua, his message was a message of peace and not of war. And yet the abomination that maketh desolate, that abomination, the filthiness that comes in, that claims to be the Messiah, or was the Catholic Church would say about Peter. Peter, they say, was the first pope, and that he is the vicar of Christ, vicarius filii Dilii, which is Latin, which means in the place of Christ. So they believe that they're taking Christ's place. And so Yeshua says, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ. And so therefore, every pope that there has ever been, that is what he's talking about, and that is many. Over 200 popes have come down through time, all claiming to be the vicar of Christ. And so that is a fulfillment of that scripture right there. Then we get into Matthew 24, 6. And you shall see what? Excuse me. And you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. Okay? See that you be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Now, we might think of World War I, World War II, and of course, World War III has always seemed to be more or less a rumor of a war, and maybe not, maybe not. It could be other nations. It could be North Korea. It could be that we're saying that we're going to go to war with North Korea, and maybe we never end up going to war with North Korea. Maybe that's always just been a rumor of a war. Or we might go to war with North Korea, or it might be Russia, the U.S. and Russia, and maybe eventually we never go to war with Russia. Nonetheless, there's supposed to be wars, plural, and rumors of wars, all right? Be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Now, I used to take this here, for nation shall rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines, pestilence, earthquakes in divers places. All these are the beginning of sorrows. And when I looked at the nation against nation, I would think the United States against Russia, kingdom against kingdom. I would think of the Middle Eastern, like the Saudis against the Turkish or the Saudis against the Syrians, because that's really what it is, a war against the Saudis or against the Syrians. And again, it's an ethnic type of war. Until Bonnie, who I do a program with her on Flashpoint on Hebrew Nation Radio, we actually normally record on Sundays. It airs on Sundays as well as two other times during the week, so you might want to catch that. But anyway, she made mention that the word nation in this case is taken from the Greek word ethnos. Ethnos means ethnic, where we get the English word ethnic at. And so it's ethnic is rising up against ethnicity, and then kingdom against kingdom. And so then I begin to look at this in light of the fact of what's happening in the world today. And if you begin to look, and let's just go back quickly, what are we dealing with that is happening in the case of the United States, Mr. Farrakhan, and not just Mr. Farrakhan. I mean, he's always done this by peaceful, expressing his opinions peacefully. He's never been about violence. I mean, I can't say that all of his speeches are like that. I've never listened to all of them. But, you know, he keeps insisting that the black people should have a state of their own. Or a certain amount of land for their own, and etc. So there again, you're dealing with an ethnic type of uprising, nation against nation, or ethnics against ethnics. And this is something that they've been trying to do in America. Even it seems like some elites in control in this country have been trying to create an ethnic war. And it has nothing to do with what Mr. Farrakhan is talking about either. It's just flat out killing each other. Sad to say, you know, and I have a love and affinity for the black community, because they have been, you know, so done evilly over the years, and still very difficult for them to move ahead in life today. But I do have a great love for the black community and our brothers and sisters there. But moving on then, we see Donetsk. It's the same thing. You know, see, nation against nation or ethnicity against ethnicity is not always just about black skin, white skin. And in the case of Donetsk, it's a Russian people versus the Western Ukrainians, who are just a different race of people. But their skin color is not that much difference. You wouldn't tell the difference just by looking at them. But in this case, it's more of an ethnic belief. One is Russian Orthodox, the other is Roman Catholic. All right, and then if you look back and you look at the Kurds, again, it's another ethnic issue. But yet the Kurds would look no different maybe than the Sunnis or the Shiites that are living in their nation, but they are a different people. and they come from a different lineage. But in reality, we all come from Noah to begin with. You know, Ham, Shem, or Japheth. We have one single grandfather, regardless of our color of our skin. The skin has only changed as the time and the areas we live at in the world today that has brought that about. So, and you go all the way back then, we look at what's happening in Italy. That's not so much an ethnic type of situation, but they say that Catalonia is an ethnic issue. Once again, that they are a different people from that of the Spaniards. So may not look as different as what we are dealing with in America, but still it is an ethnic rising up against ethnicity. And this is, there's more countries than just what I've listed, but I was just trying to give you a general idea of what's actually going on so you can physically see what is happening in the world today. And a lot of the situations like the Czech Republic has a lot to do with what's going on there. Again, it is an ethnic issue. It's the Polish side of the people living in the far east of Czech Republic against the Western side, and Eastern Europeans against Western Europeans, so to speak. And then we have, on top of that, now we have the refugee crisis going on through Europe. So now you have Arabic communities against the Anglo-Saxon type communities of Germany or England or the French community, etc., the Scandinavians. And so there's a major ethnic rising up, fighting tensions, wars that are happening, even fighting between each other. And it's not so much a war, but it's a rising up, because that's what he calls it. Nation shall rise against nation. That's not even the war. All right? So then I looked at the word for kingdom against kingdom. And as you look at that, then we do see that. We see Brexit. Now, Brexit, some would say that's not really kingdom against kingdom, but it is, because the European Union is a Roman kingdom, a Roman empire. And for Britain to leave, who is a British monarchy, to leave the European Union, that is a kingdom rising up against the kingdom of the Roman Empire and separating themselves from it. We have more than that. You also have the split with North Queensland that seeks independence, another kingdom because it's under British rule, also seeking independence, kingdom against kingdom. Perhaps even Taiwan could be considered that, although it's not necessarily a king. It's more of a, China's more of a communistic nation, but their leader is still like having a king itself. And Taiwan, still the same peoples, but totally, because it's a huge island, separating from the other one. So is this what we're seeing in biblical prophecy? Are we literally, right now, the things that are making headlines today, is this biblical prophecy fulfilling, and we've just totally missed it? That's something to really consider. I'm Stephen Benoon with the Noon Institute of Biblical Research. I trust this has been a blessing to you today. If you would like to help support the work we do, please visit our website, whether it be IsraelReturns.com. You can go there. You'll see our website there, the place to donate, as well as IsraeliNewsLive.org or .co.il, but .org. And if you happen to catch this video when it's on Israeli News Live, right above the subscribe button, we have a little donation link there. Also, our address in Prague, Czech Republic, appears at the end of the broadcast as well. We will, in the near future, be adding a U.S. mailing address for you as well. But for the time being, we're fixing to head back to Prague here in the next few weeks. So if you would like to send a gift there to us, we would greatly appreciate it. And thank you for your support. Also, thank you for those of you that have been praying for my wife, Yana. We got a little ways to go. We'll talk about things once we know a little bit more about what's going on. But we don't really know for sure yet. But we do ask for your prayers and continued prayers for her as well. God bless you. Thank you. And shalom.